Good morning to all. Today I will discuss about chapter 3, books of brain and train. Today I will discuss about source document, cash receipt, invoice, debit note, credit note, pay in slip or check. So double entry system, definition and principles. So transaction, cash transaction, bank transaction and credit transaction. Approaches of recording transaction. Accounting equation approaches, so traditional approaches. Accounting rules and journal. Next heading, source documents. Source documents are the evidences of financial transaction, so evidences of proof or bills. Goods purchasing from other person means receiving for bills also is a evidence. So deposit from bank means the pay in slip is evidence. Second point, this document show the nature of transaction. So nature of transaction means day to day life, all the business transaction recorded in book of accounts. The date, the amount. The date and amount is compulsory recorded in book of accounts. And the parties involved. For three parties involved, buyer and seller. So buyer and seller is joined from the working for middleman is compulsory. Middleman for agent or commissioner, broker. So source document include cash receipt, invoice, debit note and credit note, pay in slip, salary bills. Salary bills means so the monthly salary bills, employee salary bills. And wages means day-to-day life, daily wages or weekly wages. And check and any other form of written document proof is a compulsory for source documents evidence. Next one, cash receipt. Cash receipt, it is a document that show the date, amount and detail of cash purchase and cash sales. Only cash receipt means only cash transaction recorded in book of accounts. Cash receipt is also known as an cash received, earning from other persons or other cash transaction. Business person receive cash receipt for cash purchase and issue cash receipt for cash sale. Next one, invoice. So invoice means only credit transaction. Invoice is used for credit purchase and credit sale. Only credit transaction. The date, amount, detail of credit purchase and credit sales are given in the invoice. So invoice is generally prepared for three copies. Only seller preparing three copies. First one, purchaser. Second copy, send along with the goods and checking. Third copy, retained by the seller and used as the source document for the recording the transaction is the evidence of source document. So invoice specimen, this is a invoice specimen. So tax invoice bill, sold by, selling person name. So shipping address and billing address. So billing address, same invoice number, invoice date, same product name. So product name, description, quantity, one or two quantity, gross amount, total amount. So 5,000 rupees means 1,000. So discount, 10% means 10% discount. Tax valuable and IGST, goods service tax, total amount. Second one, shipping charges or 40% shipping charges means 40 rupees or 10 rupees added, total amount. Total price, no shipping charges means zero value. Total price 535 rupees. So invoice bill. Same is the order ID. Total quantity 1. 2 or 3 means 2 or 3. It's a invoice. This is a invoice of tax invoice. Next one, debit note. A buyer may return the goods to the seller in various situations. So buyer may return the goods to the seller in various situations. So goods damaged. means return from the seller, such as when the goods are defective or damaged, goods do not meet the specification, etc., or any problems returned to the seller. When the goods are returned by a seller, the buyer prepare debit note and send it to the seller. So debit note, two copies are prepared in general, prepare for general person. First copy send to the seller. Seller means sales person. Second copy retained by the buyer, written copy. Next one, credit note. It is a statement prepared by the seller who receive back from his customer the goods sold. Sold means sales. It contain detail such as a description of the goods, reason, quantity return, which how many quantity return from buyer, and also the value. Say description means this is a description value, description which quantity description. So HSN 74181022, this quantity means, so which quantity return, quantity 5 means 5, 7 means 7, 7 rupee, 7 quantity value, same total value, 7 quantity, same total quantity value, 7 means 7 goods, 7 quantity goods return means 7 quantities. Next one, pay in slip. So when cash or check is deposited in a bank, a form is to be filled by a customer and submit to the banker along with the cash or check. This is called pay in slip or deposit slip. This is a pay in slip format. So pay in slip. So State Bank of India. So date is compulsory. Type of account, saving account, current account, recurring current account, term deposit account. Same. The credit of the bank account of account holder name. Next one, same amount cash deposit in the amount means 5000 means 5000 rupees. Rupees 5000 means 5000. Cash handling check means check number. Total deposit amount rupees 5000 rupees means 5000 rupees only. So cash officer, passing officer signature. Same next one, same pay in slip, account number. So compulsory account number is given, same branches name, date, account number, the credit of the bank account of accounter name. Next, rupees inwards, 5000 rupees deposited means 5000 rupees only, code number. Next one, so details of cash, check off, check. Cash deposit in the account. Cash deposit means 10,000 rupees. Deposit means 10,000 rupees. Next one, telephone number is compulsory. Total deposit amount. PAN number is compulsory. So, signature of the depositor. Deposit is a pay in slip. Pay in slip form. So, back side, how many 2,000 rupees? How many note? 1,000 is how many note? So details of cash, 10,000 means 2,000 into 2,000 amount means 2,000 rupees, 2,000 into 2, 4,000, 1,000 into 1, 1,000, 500 into 3 means 1,500 total amount. It's a pay in slip. Next one, check. Check is a negotiable checkbook. It's issued by the bank to its customer for withdrawing money for own use, for making payment to the others. It's a checkbook. So first page, record slip. Record slip means, so only accounting holder future use, accounting holder using for futures. Check is issued to amount of check, amount of deposit. It's a check. It's a pay. It's a check. Pay means So transfer from one person to other person means so other person name, so other person account name. So only withdraw for myself, withdraw for personal use or own use means self, mention for self. Rupees, so only bulk amount 1 lakh or 2 lakh or 3 lakh. So 1 lakh rupees only. So date, month, year 26/04/2020. So rupees means 10,000, 1 lakh. Next one, same, so account number. Signature, please sign above. Same is the account detail name. One, so check number one. Same, pay means one person to another person, transfer to check means so other person account holding name. Same, own personal, withdraw from own personal or office use means office account number or own personal number or self, mention for self. Rupees, same, check back side, sign and phone number or signature, sign and phone number, so checkbook. Next one, double entry system. So double entry system, according to this system, every transaction has to twofold effect. That is, there are two aspects involved, namely receiving aspect, incoming aspect, giving aspect means expenses aspect. It is notated by debit means DR and credit means CR. Debit notes denoted an increasing in asset or expenses. Asset value increase or expenses value increasing means debit side. Decreasing in liability, income for decreasing means sir, credit side. Say credit denotes on increasing in liability, income or capital, decreasing in asset or expenses. Principles of double entry system. In every business transaction, there are two aspects, for giving aspect or receiving aspect. The two aspects involved are the benefit or value receiving aspect and benefit of value giving aspect. These two aspects involve minimum two accounts, debit account and credit account also. For every debit, there is a corresponding and equivalent of credit also. If one account is debited, the another account must be credited. Next one, transaction. Say transaction means involves transfer of monies and money's worth from one person to another person. So transaction including for three transactions. First one, cash transaction. Second one, bank transaction. Third one, credit transaction. First one, cash transaction. So cash transaction, when immediately cash is involved in a transaction, it is called cash transaction. Or immediately paid to others means so cash transaction. Bank transaction, in a transaction, if a bank is involved in a bank transaction, only check, withdraw from bank, any check transfer to one person to another person is also bank transaction. So bank transaction includes cash deposit into bank or cash paid into bank. Income of the business directly received by the bank. CDM, cash deposit machine. Payment made by the customer of the business through debit card, credit card, net banking, NEFT, National Electrical Fund Transfer, RTGS, Real Time Gross Settlement, etc. Next one, credit transaction. When settlement is not made by cash or through bank immediately in a credit transaction. Not paid to immediately means the credit transaction. So next one, approaches of recording transaction. First one, accounting equation approaches. So accounting equation approaches means capital plus liability is equal to asset. So capital plus liability is equal to asset. So capital can also called as owner equity and liability outsider equity. So accounting equation means is a mathematical expression which shows that total asset equal to the total liability and capital. This is based on the dual aspect concept of accounting. Dual aspect means receiving aspect and giving aspect. The means the total claims of the outsider at the preparator will always be equal. Total asset of the enterprises. Same, next one. Assets equal to liabilities plus capital plus revenue minus expenses. Therefore, under this approaches, accounts are classified 5 categories. First one, asset. Second one, liabilities. Third one, capital. Fourth one, revenue. Fifth one, expenses. First one, asset account. Any physical thing or right owned that a monetary value is called asset. Or this asset are grouped or shown separately for tangible asset or intangible asset or current asset or fixed asset. Say example, land and building account or plant and machinery account also. Liability. Liability means financial obligation, return payable to other person. Liability means return payable to outsider. Towards outsider are shown under separate heads of liability. Say example, creditors account and expenses outstanding account or bills payable account, etc. Next one, capital. So financial application of a business enterprises towards its owner are grouped under this category. So capital, example, capital contribution by the owner or partners. Revenue account means accounting related to the revenue of an enterprises are grouped under this category. Same, revenue from sale of goods or rent received. So selling from other person means is a revenue account, income earning person. Expenses incurred and losses suffered for earning revenue are grouped under this category. Purchase of goods, example, purchase of goods, salaries paid, etc. Next approaches, traditional approaches. Classifications of accounts. So personal account, impersonal account, natural, artificial, representative. So impersonal, real and nominal. Real is an intangible asset. Here real, tangible or intangible account. First one, so personal account. So personal account which are related to the natural person or artificial representative is also called as an personal account. There are first one, natural account. So natural accounts means accounts which are related to individuals. For example, Mohan's account, Rajesh account, Sukumar account and Shantakumar account, etc. Artificial person means accounts which are related to group of person or firm or institution. Or example, Islamia Matriculation Higher Secondary School is a institution. Or HMT Limited or Indian Overseas Bank and Life Insurance Corporation, say etc. Representative person means accounts which represent a particular person or group of person. Say example, outstanding salary account, say individual person account and prepaid insurance account, etc. Next one, impersonal account. Impersonal account, first one, real. Real means accounts related to the properties, so asset, properties and asset which are owned by the business concern or comes under a real account. Only asset is a real account. So for example, tangible asset for intangible asset. So for example, land, building, goodwill, purchase, cash, etc. So next one, nominal account. This account do not have any existence for a from or safe. They are related to incomes and expenses and gains and losses of a business concern. For example, salary account and dividend account, etc. Next one, so accounting rules is a compulsory 3-mark question accounting rules. So golden rules of double entry system. Golden rules of double entry system. Personal account. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. Personal account. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. Real account. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Real account. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Nominal account. Debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. Nominal account. Debit all expenses and gains, credit all incomes and gains. So example sum 5. Classify the following into personal, real and nominal account. A. Capital. B. Building. C. Carriage inward. D. Cash. E. Commission received. F. Bank. G. Purchase. H. Chandru. I. Outstanding wages. So personal account means individual person name or individual deposited from bank or company. So personal account means, so personal account individual person name or deposit from bank or deposited from contribution for capital in company means, so personal account. Real account means only asset, intangible asset or fixed asset, any asset means, so real account. So nominal account means only expenses or incomes, losses, all item were nominal account. First one, capital. So capital, contribution for bank or contribution for businessman. So a deposit from bank or contribution. So start from business means, so business partnership contribution for capital. So personal account or individual person contribution of capital means, so personal account. Building. Building is a asset. Asset means real account. Building is a tangible asset or building is a tangible asset. So real account. So carriage inward. So a carriage inward means daily wages payable to workers means carriage inward, or 7 days once payable to workers means expenses, nominal account. Cash means real account is a cash in hand or cash at bank. So or individual person deposit from bank means, so only profit, earning from profit means deposit from bank or cash in hand, etc. So real account, cash is a asset. Commission received. Received means income. All incomes or expenses or income, nominal account. Bank is a personal account. So deposit from bank means individual person deposit from bank. So personal account. Purchase, say expenses. Any goods or machinery purchasing means say expenses. So nominal account. Chandru, individual person name. Individual person name means, so personal account. Outstanding wages. Outstanding wages means is a individual person payable to workers for personal account. Same capital is a contribution capital for personal account. So personal account means individual person name or deposit from bank or so capital account means individual person name, cash deposit from bank or contribution of capital in company means personal account. Real account means only asset, any one asset or a tangible asset or intangible asset or fixed asset, any asset name means given means is a real account. Nominal account means only expenses, any expenses is given, so monthly expenses, 7 days expenses or direct expenses is given means is a nominal account. Next one, sum number 1. Complete the accounting equation. Complete the accounting equation. A. Assets equal to capital plus liabilities. Asset value 1 lakh, capital value 80,000, liabilities value not given. Question number B. Assets equal to capital plus liabilities. Asset value 2 lakh, capital value not given, liabilities value 40,000. C. Asset not given, capital value 1,60,000, creditors or liabilities value 80,000. Question number A. Asset is equal to capital plus liability. So asset value 1 lakh and capital value 80,000 given. Liabilities value not given. So calculation of liabilities equal to asset minus capital. So calculation of liabilities equal to asset minus capital. Asset value 1 lakh, capital value 80,000. So balance 20,000 liabilities value. Same. 1 lakh minus 80,000, balance 20,000 rupees. Same B. Asset question B. Assets equal to capital plus liabilities. capital value 2 lakhs, capital asset, sorry, asset value 2 lakh, capital value not given, liabilities value 40,000. So calculation of capital is equal to asset minus liabilities. Asset value 2 lakh, liability value 40,000, 2 lakh minus 40,000, balance 1,60,000. Same capital value 1,60,000 means 1,60,000 plus 40,000, asset value 2 lakh. See, assets equal to capital plus creditors. Asset value not given, capital value 1,60,000 and creditors value 80,000 rupees. Assets equal to capital plus liability or creditor. Capital value 1,60,000, liability value 80,000, total value 2,40,000. Same 1,60,000 plus 80,000, asset value 2,40,000. Next, assignment 4. Question number 1. Give the golden rules of double entry accounting system. Or personal example, personal account, real account and nominal account. Second one, complete the accounting equation. A, assets equal to capital plus liability. Asset value rupees 30,000. So capital value not given, liabilities value 20,000. So calculation of capital value. Second one, assets equal to capital plus liability. Asset value not given, capital value 25,000, liabilities value 30,000, calculation of asset value. C, assets equal to capital plus liabilities or creditors. Asset value rupees 25,000, capital value 15,000, so calculation of liabilities value.